Well, we've got, if anything, a slightly more hawkish Fed than anticipated. They have increased the pace of the taper, going to $30 billion a month. It's going to be $20 billion in treasuries and $10 billion in mortgages, as expected. They've raised their inflation forecast and dropped the word transitory in talking about inflation. Now they see PCE inflation, their headline number, at 5.3% for this year, dropping all the way to 2.6% in 2022 and 2.1% by 2024. Core PCE 4.4% this year and 2.7% next year. And yet, the dot plot shows the anticipation of three rate moves next year, three more in 2023, and almost three more after that in 2024. A big dispersion. Of course, you can't count on that, but they do see having to move relatively more aggressively than people might have thought. They do replace the word transitory, as I mentioned, in the statement saying about inflation, supply and demand imbalances related to the pandemic and the reopening of the economy have continued to contribute to elevated levels of inflation. The sectors most adversely affected by the pandemic have improved in recent months, but continue to be affected by COVID-19. With inflation having exceeded 2% for some time, the committee expects it will be appropriate to maintain the target range. They did not move rates today until labor market conditions have reached levels consistent with the committee's assessments of maximum employment. So one of the questions for Jay Powell today is certainly going to be, what are those conditions that would be consistent with maximum employment if you're already there on the inflation mandate? And the committee also says that progress on vaccinations and easing of supply constraints are expected to support continued gains in economic activity and employment, as well as a reduction in inflation. But risks to the economic outlook remain, including from new variants of the virus. So a lot of decisions by the Fed charting a new course going forward here. We can mention the decision unanimous.